We all tend to struggle with trying to figure out our purpose in life. You know, maybe you've got the good job or you're in a good relationship, or maybe just things are going well, but you don't feel fulfilled. And maybe you're wondering what the point of life is, what your purpose is, or how to make life meaningful and actually make it feel like it's worth living. Now in this video, I want to share what I think are the two reasons why you are here on Earth. And if you focus on these two things, your life will be deeply meaningful, no matter how good and no matter how bad. Hey guys, Alex Hine, author of the book Master the Day. Now, if you're looking to create a more meaningful life, one of the best ways is through journaling. So I've included the first link in the description is for a free journaling worksheet that'll help you figure out how to plan out a meaningful, exciting life. You're also going to get a weekly email on how to use journaling to reinvent yourself and find meaning and purpose. So click the first link in the description to check that out. So when I was in my 20s, I had this weird feeling, this weird phenomenon happen where I had a good job, I had my bills being paid, I had family, I was close to them, I had friends, I had a serious girlfriend, and I had travel. Like, I had enough money to do a vacation every year, but underneath everything was a low level of anxiety or nihilism or this kind of pessimistic, like, what's the point? What's the point? I have everything I want and need from like a conscious perspective, but I'm not fulfilled. I don't know why I don't feel that happy. Like, I just feel every day. And that scared me. Because if I had everything I was supposed to want and need in a healthy way, but I wasn't feeling fulfilled, what was the point of life? And around that time, I realized there were two things. And when you have these two things, life is always deeply meaningful, no matter where you are, whether it's good or whether it's bad. So the first reason I believe you are here is for following something that comes through your intuition and your dharma. Now, your dharma is this concept that there's this kind of divine purpose of your life. There's a purpose you're supposed to fulfill. And even though I don't focus on the concept of dharma that much, for me in my own life, as I struggled in my 20s to find purpose and to find meaning, to try to realize what I was supposed to do, it was interesting because around the time of I was 25 or 26, I was trying deeply to figure out the work that I was passionate about. And I was reading Robert Greene's book, Mastery. And it was about all these old classical masters throughout history, Einstein, Da Vinci, modern masters, sports, music, everything. And as I was reading this book, I kind of had this daydream about the kind of person I wanted to become. I had this daydream about this Merlin-esque figure, alchemist, physician, making herbs up in a laboratory, the ivory tower. And I had this overwhelming feeling of excitement, goosebumps, and intrigue. And I was like, that's what I'm supposed to become. That was my passion since I was a kid. I was always into medicine and mysticism and herbs and the intersection of all those things. And so it felt like I had almost remembered something that I had forgotten previously. And ever since I realized that, and then went back the next year to interview at all of these schools to do my doctorate in Chinese medicine, and my lifelong GI problems were fixed through Chinese medicine. It was only after doing that, that I had the feeling that I never ever had once in my life. That instead of looking for purpose and meaning, instead of looking for my passion or some work that I was supposed to deeply care about, I was now pursuing a path that I felt like I was born to do. I was looking previously feeling lost. Do I do that? Do I do that? Do I do that? But now, I felt like I was on the path of pursuit, the pursuit of meaning. And I'd already found the path. And it was just how deep, how far can I go down this path that I already know is the right path. And that sense of peace, that decrease in the feeling of restlessness inside of me was incredible. And it's gone away ever since. I feel like I'm doing the work I was born to do. So in your own life, maybe there is something you intuitively feel drawn to that you cannot explain. I cannot explain why this field is the one that's my passion. I just know how I feel about it. Maybe there's something intuitively you feel like you should be doing. You're a lawyer, but you feel like you should be doing art. You're someone who's doing an engineering degree, but what you love is horse riding. You're someone who's really, really drawn to graphic design, but somehow you ended up being a painter or a mechanic. Find a way to do both until you can move more towards that intuition. and follow those little callings, especially the work callings in your life that you don't know why you're drawn to them, but some aspect of you is so drawn to this field or this interest. Don't overanalyze it, just follow it. So that, I believe, is the first purpose of life. If every day you follow your natural inclinations, you follow your intuition for some topic or some field, follow your intuition. That's the first thing. It will lead you to some kind of thing that will have synchronicity, deep fulfillment, success, all of that. The second thing is that I believe a fundamental purpose of life is to get better, is to grow. You know, I don't think there is a fixed, this is the purpose of your life, Jimmy, but guaranteed, if you focus on growth as one of the main drivers of your life, no matter the divorce, the death, the heartbreak, the sickness, the financial poverty, all the issues that come up, the depression, the anxiety, if you focus on getting better, you will eventually overcome every single one of those things. So if you begin to embody that growth, getting better is a divine purpose of my life, then no matter what happens, you're always going to be focused on growing, your life's always going to get better, and you will always get better. And that guarantees in the future, you will not have to have that adversity necessarily anymore. Or if you do, at the very least, you will be the kind of person who can now overcome it without a doubt. Because if you're going through one of those hard times right now, if you're saying, this is so stupid, what did I do to deserve this? This is his fault, her fault, my parents' fault, genetics, the president. If you're in blame mode, you're not going to get better. But if you're saying to yourself, you know, I'm here to get better, then that is now your mission and your purpose. You're driven by something, you're going to improve your life, and you're guaranteed going to get out of it at some point. So when you embody this trait of, I'm here to get better, everything in life's an opportunity. Illness is an opportunity. Death is an opportunity. Sickness, divorce, happiness, all these things are opportunities to get better. So otherwise, if you think that life is just about pleasure and about fun, what happens when shit hits the fan? What happens when there is death or divorce or sickness or whatever it is? Then you're like, well, no, the purpose of my life is fun. I'd rather be doing coke and drinking at the bars and having multiple relationships and traveling and not working. But that kind of life doesn't lead to meaning or to growth. And so when you get stuck, and we all inevitably get stuck at some point with something, that's very difficult to get out of. So I believe behind everything, if you cultivate two beliefs, number one, there's a divine purpose for my life. My intuition will lead me to that thing or those people, and then listen to it. And number two, that the purpose of life is to get better. And if you focus on self-growth, any challenges will eventually be overcome. If you do those two things, your life will have so much purpose and meaning that you will forget that at one stage of your life, you were wondering what the point and what the purpose of your life really was. So I hope that helps you guys. That's helped me a lot through my 20s. Again, if you're trying to find purpose and meaning, click the first link in the description to download the free journaling worksheet, because it's also going to give you an email every 3 or so days on how to use journaling to reinvent yourself and find purpose and meaning in your life. So click the first link in the description, then you can come on over and watch the related videos to this video right there and right there.